regreso aquí en Auto 060. Estamos llegando al show que está en la segunda parte. Hemos dedicado al regreso, así que tuvimos la lista ahí de Kelley Blue Book, el top 10 list de los mejores autos para el regreso a clases. And now we're gonna switch back to English because we're gonna talk about the topics, like the things that people should be aware when they are going back to school in a new car or in a used car. So we're gonna talk to Michael Calkins from AAA to talk about this. How are you, Michael?
Real good, Javier. It's nice to be with you.
Thank you very much for the time. So as I was mentioning in the intro there in Spanish, we just talk about the top 10 list for the best cars to go back to school for college students. And so this is a perfect match because AAA just came up with a list of the things that people should be aware of when they are going back to school. And there are like so many things that students and parents along are like worrying about. So, and they probably forget about checking the car, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, there's about 22 million students going back to school.
Wow.
And a lot of those students have cars, and people think about all the stuff that they need to do, and they don't realize that one thing they don't talk to their kids about is the need to properly maintain their vehicle while they're away from home.
Yeah, exactly. And most parents, I'm not a parent myself, but most people forget to take care of their cars, period. I mean, it doesn't matter if it's going to college and vacation, to work or what. I mean, like, I just had a conversation recently, like somebody was asking me, so how long, how often should I check the pressure in the tires, for example? I mean, like, they have no, most people have no idea. I'm not going to say everybody, but most people.
Yeah, I think most people's right. You know, we all have very busy lives today, especially college students are very busy with the stuff. So, you know, when you get talking about changing tires, what AAA recommends is check your tires at least once a month. You know, when the tires are cold, make sure they're inflated to the pressure that's on the decal you'll find on the driver's door jamb.
Yeah, and why it's important when it's cold? I mean, like, what? And we're talking cold. Obviously, that varies from state to state here in the and all around the country. But so, when you mention cold, what does that mean?
Well, when we say cold, we mean when the vehicle hasn't been driven for like 6 hours or so.
You know, okay.
Like first thing in the morning is a good time, because what happens is as the car is driven, the tire creates friction against the road, which raises the temperature. And the tire pressures will actually go up 3 or 4 pounds from cold to hot. So the specifications are designed to be checked when the tire has not been driven for a while and the temperature is stabilized.
Yeah. And this is obviously the same for new or used cars. What about when the tires are a bit old in a used car? I read recently that even if a car has not been driven for a long time and the tires look new, if a car has been sitting for a long time, the tire might not be very well, right?
Well, you know, there's a lot of controversy about this. Some of the tire manufacturers are saying that you should replace a tire after 6 years, regardless of how much tread it has on it. AAA doesn't go quite that far, but you do need to look at the condition of the tire. You know, if a vehicle is parked in the sun 24/7, well,
yeah,
you wouldn't have sun 24/7, but in the sun every day, the tires will get what's called checked on the outside. The rubber will get real dry and cracked, and definitely a tire like that should be replaced. But a car that's stored indoors all the time, you know, the tires don't suffer the same amount of degradation over time, and you could probably get a little more than 6 years. But reality is, for the typical driver, you're going to wear the tires out before 6 years.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, unless you have a collectible car, and you wouldn't be driving that back to college.
No, right? Probably not taking it to school. No.
Yeah, exactly. So let's go to the second point on your list: the maintenance schedule. Again, like, college students have like so many things in their minds, not only like the classes they attend, the student loans that they get into to go to college. So maintenance is something that is sometimes can be expensive, but if you don't do it, it can be even more expensive, right?
Absolutely. I think maintenance definitely comes behind parties and the college student's lifestyle. What we recommend is that if your child's car is coming up with a need for maintenance service, why don't you get that done before they go off to school? You know, make sure it's in tip-top shape. You know, if the life of a battery is only 3 to 5 years, so if you got an older battery, have it checked out, you know, before you go. AAA's mobile battery service can do that for you. Just do everything you can in advance to make sure that the maintenance is all up to date. And that kind of relieves the student of the need to monitor that, unless they drive a lot of miles at school.
Yeah. And another thing, is speaking about maintenance, regular maintenance, what about the oil? I mean, like, it would be a good idea to change to synthetic oil instead of a mineral oil, because the synthetic oil lasts for much, much longer.
Well, I think that, you know, that it could possibly help. You know, again, I'm not sure how much students drive when they're away at school. You know, if they're going to put more than than 4,000 or 5,000 miles on the car, then that might be a good suggestion. The other thing you can do is find a good repair shop near the college. You know, visit AAA.com/repair and find one of our approved repair shops that's nearby. And then when the student goes to school, maybe the parents go with them, stop by the shop, talk to the people, you know, get their business card to put in the glove box. That way, if there is a problem or they need some maintenance, they know where they can go and get the work done with confidence.
Yeah. And the other thing, I mean, prepare for roadside emergencies. Like, they're going to happen, especially if, like, college students don't have a brand new car. If it's a used car, it might have some problems. So that's a very important thing to do, right, to get ready before the emergency comes up to you.
Yeah, you know, plan ahead. You have that emergency kit in the car with the flashlight and the blanket and batteries, jumper cables, first aid kit. You know, tire pressure gauge, depending on where they're going to school, you know, if it's a place up north where you got cold winter weather, you want to make sure you're prepared for that. So you have an ice scraper, a snow brush, and that type of stuff. And also a membership in a motor club like AAA. So if something does happen, that they can call and have someone come and help them when you're not available to do it yourself.
Yeah. This next topic that I'm going to mention is not on your list, but what do you think of the recommendation of getting a manual transmission car for kids? Because that way they're going to have one hand busy, like changing gears and not on the cell phone. What do you think about that?
I have not really considered that, but it makes a lot of sense to me. On the other hand, you know, driving a manual transmission car is a skill that's kind of disappearing today. So I kind of like the idea in that you teach kids how
something new, right?
Something new, but that's not a bad idea.
Yeah, and I've been hearing that. Unfortunately, as you say, I mean the automatic transmissions are getting so good and like so efficient that it does. I mean, they even like are more efficient with the MPG. So I don't know, but maybe that's something that people might consider. So, Michael, where can people find out more about all the great advice that AAA gives to the public?
Well, the easiest way is just to visit AAA.com and explore from there. All of our sites have automotive pages with detailed information, and it's a good place to go.
You have about 53 million members, right?
That's right. Yep.
And,
one in every four households.
What about the membership fees? How are there just one, or are there like different plans, and how does that work?
It varies from club to club. AAA is a federation. It's made up of 43 different clubs, so there's a little bit of variation, but it typically runs, you know, if you have a student, if you have a AAA membership, you can add your student as an associate member at a much reduced rate. So,
yeah. Okay. Thank you very much, Michael, from AAA with advice for car lessons to go back to college this fall. So thank you very much, Michael, and talk to you soon.
Thank you, Javier.
Thank you. Pues ahí tiene las recomendaciones de la AAA para el regreso a clases, mantener la presión de los neumáticos, mantener el orden de mantenimiento, el calendario a tiempo, buscar un taller cerca de la universidad, del college donde van los chicos, y tener un plan para las emergencias antes de que estas ocurran. Así que muy interesante. Y como con todas las otras entrevistas que hemos tenido en este show aquí en Auto 060 en Cristina Radio Network, estamos colocando todos los links, la información, las listas en nuestra página de Facebook, facebook.com/auto060, para que tengan la información. Así que muchas gracias a DJ Cafa y en los controles en la producción de este show. Y en la próxima semana vamos a estar en Pebble Beach, en California, así que vamos a traer muchas entrevistas de todo lo que viene en los autos, sobre todo autos de lujo para el 2014, el 2015, el 2016, porque vamos a ver una gran cantidad de autos prototipos y los autos de producción. Así que esto ha sido Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota y los espero en una edición más aquí en Cristina Radio Network, en SiriusXM Radio, el canal 153.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.